Sorry. Okay. Let's meet our next guest now. My next guest's father come from Donegal. The mammy came from Wicklow. He was reared in Scotland, came to Ireland in 1976, fell in love with the place, delighted with it, and decided not to go away. And he went on to become one of the country's best-known and best-loved entertainers. Now, to remind us of the impact he had in the streets of the towns and cities, but particularly and most especially Dublin, and specifically and most especially Grafton Street, take a look at this edited excerpt from Louis Marcus's series called The Entertainers. Roll it there, Ray, please. The Entertainers. The Dice Man, Tom McGinty. The Dice Man.
You're not going to sit in that all night. You couldn't be. No, you're not. No, you're not. Dump it on the floor. Dump it on the floor. There you are now with your crown and everything. Come in, come down and sit there.
That's Cahill.
Nice.
That's Jeannie.
How you doing?
Now, I want to say to you... that somebody said something to you in Moore Street during that filming.
They did, yeah. I was going back up the road and I said, this voice came from behind me and said, hey, mister, I hope you don't get the AIDS off of that. And 2 years later, at 11:45 on Friday the 6th of December, I discovered I was HIV positive and was carrying the AIDS virus. So I've been living with that for the last 4 years. So this is the big mystery of the mysterious illness that has been written about. You know, I mean, it says, oh, he's seriously ill. I mean, if it was meningitis or anything or cancer, they'd say, you know. But I was a wee bit kind of surprised, but I've had girls in the street saying to me, oh, there's the Dice Man, he's dying of AIDS, you know, because their brothers would have seen me up at the clinic. But I'm very much living with AIDS, you know. And I was very well up until, say, March there, and then June things got very bad. I don't know how my mind or Aidan Murphy, wherever he is a saint, and Winnie Ryan as well for putting up with me. But when this started happening, we'd started to develop an agency because there was some jobs I couldn't do, I didn't think I was suitable for. So I said to Aidan, right, we do not, this is a crazy, as Rock Hudson said, the crazy adventure that is AIDS, and that's what it is, a crazy adventure. So build up that agency, you know, which he has done, and it's now earning him a living, because I can't earn any more. I'm on the DP, MA, all these initials, you know, HIV.
How did you react, Tom, when you were told?
I felt as if I'd been hit by a sledgehammer, and lots of people I've talked to have used the same expression. And I was in a state of shock for about 8 months, and another 5 months after that, I was fully on my feet. I was going to group therapy. I never thought I'd be getting into all these, you know, hip 60s things like that, you know. But because it is a nightmare, and I mean, I'd like to say to anybody out there who has just received that diagnosis, that to write into the Gay Burn and let me talk to them, you know, because it's not, you can talk to your counsellor or somebody who isn't positive and they don't really know what the hell that is. I mean, cancer is one thing, meningitis is another, but AIDS is such a taint to it, you know. But unfortunately, with the news last week about the state of health, some people have been saying, or a guy, one guy in particular, come up to you and said, oh, I was going to phone you up, but here you're out of business, you know. But I'm out of business. Aiden is in business. Right, the agency is still working.
But you got a terrific reaction on the benefit night in the
US. Well, the benefit night was, I mean, I felt I could go public after I couldn't work because it wouldn't affect my business that way.
And have you done working now?
Well, I'm done working. I can't work. I've got this atrophy of the brain, which sounds lethal, but it's only mild atrophy, whatever that means. And it's affected my balance. I can't actually perform. I can't actually project that performing presence. It's like a dancer losing their ability to dance, you know.
And have you had negative reaction, Tom?
No.
Surely not. No.
There's also, I mean, there's very funny things about this. I mean, there's some people who are alive today who wouldn't be alive today if they hadn't been HIV positive because they got into looking after themselves, you know, and all this kind of stuff, you know. That's just kind of one of the examples. Or the guy who, when he got his diagnosis, got out a video of death in Venice, you know, which is a bit, you know, you have, it is a crazy adventure, you know.
And what is the worst fear you have now?
The worst fear I have? Dementia. I can cope with the blindness and things like that, but dementia is, I don't like, and the atrophy of the brain, well, it's a normal part of the ageing process, and age accentuates all that, you know. But I've had no negative reaction. I mean, the concert the other night was just, I wish you could all have been here, some of you were. It was just stunning. The Olympia was over full, 1,400, we took in 15 grand, which sounds a lot, but in fact we worked it out, and it only lasted me 2 years. But I'm working and I occupy myself working with masks, writing, doing a bit of watercolour.
And is there a prognosis? Have you been given any time?
No, there is no time. I mean, there's people I know who would have been positive since 1982 and they're still healthy, you know. But the kind of, you go in there and for the first year they never did a T-cell count until I got candida in the mouth, they did, and T cells were 180. Once they go down below 200, they start freaking and put you on AZT and all these highly poisonous drugs, you know. But I take all my medication and that, you know. But
do you miss working on the street? You do.
I miss working on Grafton Street. Yeah. I don't miss having to get from Sligo at 10 o'clock in the night, performing to the Rose of Tralee at lunchtime the next day, you know. I don't miss that travelling. I thought it was crazy, you know. And no matter what you did, something would always happen. There'd be a booking in from a year ago that you missed because your calendar ends on a Saturday and begins on a Sunday in the week of it, you know. It's kind of
and
crazy.
You weren't the best bookkeeper anyway, I suppose. No, indeed. Yes, sir. Yes, I'll come down to you. Yes, sir.
I was going to ask you again, does your lifestyle post-diagnosis differ greatly from your lifestyle pre-diagnosis?
You betcha.
Have you changed a lot in any way?
Very much so, yeah. That's why I mean by a lot of people being healthier, because of it, because I was probably drinking too much, you know. I'm sleeping better, eating better. Lifestyle has changed to sauntering around Grafton Street, drinking cappuccino and all the trendy restaurants, you know,
trendy bars,
and a lot of socialisation. The amount of people today who have come up and said to me, sorry to hear your illness, you know, and I hope you get better, and I'll say, well, I won't, it's age, you know, and watch the light late tonight and you'll find out all about it. Well, one thing about, I've had so many cards, Gay, you know, with money and things, and from people I don't know. Would those people please send me their addresses into here so that I can thank them, you know?
Okay, will do. Yes, sir.
I'd just like to say, Tom, like, you know, well done for coming on the show tonight, because I hope that, you know, you, by you appearing on the show tonight, that will dispel all the myths and ignorance about AIDS in Ireland, you know.
I think it's a very important that there was, I heard there was somebody on the other rival show who was very kind of...
What rival show?
I daren't mention his name.
You dare not talk.
The roof will collapse, the lights will blow up. But, sorry, what did you say to me then?
Well, it's just, you're such a part of Dublin culture, you know, that, you know, people know who you are.
Yeah.
You know, you have many, many fans in Dublin.
Yeah, it's odd because, I mean, it was something that's totally accidental. I was broke. I was out begging, literally, with a sheet in my hand saying, in love with the country but unable to gain employment, please give generously, thank you. You know? And so it was... it's been overwhelming, and that's why I decided originally to come out in a press conference next week, but...
Yeah, lady in green, yes.
I'm from Scotland. I wish you all the very best.
Oh, all the best to yourself, hey.
Would you come home to us? Or will you stay here?
Oh, I'll stay here.
Where are you from?
I was born in Scotland, but yes. I was here from 6 weeks old, and then every summer my mother, with four children on the boat, trying to not let us swing around the railings.
I can't believe it. You sound as if you just come over today.
Well,
yes, he does. Yes, he does.
So right. Do you. Yeah. But you'd never lose the Scottish accent.
Yeah, well, indeed. Even Sean Connery couldn't.
All the best to you.
Hello, yeah.
I just wanted to ask, do you feel, as being diagnosed HIV positive, that there have been any accurate or adequate dramatisations in either film, television or books?
No, I do not, and I severely object to the... I watched...
Philadelphia?
Philadelphia, yeah. I watched Long Time Companion as well, and there was an AIDS thing, 6 days before diagnosis, and I thought they were great movies. After it, I thought, my God, you know, what is this? Because that's all you see, and it's like Philadelphia, I think, should be banned. It is obscene, because you're watching somebody fade away frame by frame, and for someone who's had that diagnosis, that is a nightmare. I don't know how long I have actually been positive. It could be, it's at least from the early 80s because of sexual activity and safe sex activity, you know, so, and that's 12 years, you know, and I've evolved. There's a line in Marianne Faithfull's Sister Morphine: things are not what they seem, turn your nightmares into dreams, and I feel that's what I've done, you know.
Would you actually be interested in trying to produce one yourself? Or assisting?
Produce a film?
Well,
I wouldn't do a drama, I would do a film, but I'm not really a filmmaker.
Or writing, even, just attempt to put...
Oh, well, writing, yeah, we'll tell the stories, and we'll tell, you know, a few other stories, you know. Like, Harry was a good time girl, shaved his legs, then he was a she. It's about a particular guy I knew who... But he was...
but
he was a wonderful man, because he was a man who was never dying. He was always living. He went over to the Canaries a few weeks before his death. He had a holiday... Oh, he'd been in Boston and then he'd a holiday planned. He went down to favourite place in Carrasavine, went a walk, made everybody Brandy Alexander, and went to sleep.
What a way to go. Sorry, there's a young lady down here, first of all. Yes.
I'd just like to ask him, the clip that was on the telly, the entertainers, and even the way that you came in tonight, you seem very flamboyant and into making statements. Do you miss that, having given up your work? Do you miss being
on the
streets?
No, because I think I will still be making statements. I've plans to kind of make figures that I could wheel or get somebody to wheel up and down Grafton Street. And also there's plans for a coffee book, but there's also plans to erect a statue to me in the middle of Grafton Street. And the rest of them are all dead, James Joyce and Molly Malone.
In your case, how will they tell the difference, Dan?
That's
the
problem. Oh, he's not moving. Look at me, he's not moving.
Yes.
Isn't he marvellous?
Hi, now that, like, you've given up work and stuff, are there any burning ambitions that you'd like to do that you've never done before and you feel now you'd like to maybe go to Tibet or do whatever you want to do that you've never had a chance to?
No, I don't think I've been doing a lot of travelling. I don't travel very well. The last time I travelled, I ended up not remembering leaving Prestwick Airport and... end on the Maryhill Road with my head on the pavement, you know.
Is there anything else you'd like to do?
Is there anything else I'd like to do?
No, yeah.
Well, I'm doing some, well, the mass making, singing. And I've got a track on Gavin Friday's new album coming out that I'm interested in. I'll do what I can. I've actually found it's opened my, there's a new life for me, you know. It's, you know, lose your dreams and you might lose your mind, you know.
Yeah. Yes, love. Sorry. Yeah.
Would you ever think of going into fashion design?
Yeah, and I'm very insulted that I haven't been invited on Head to Toe yet.
An invitation to get you on fashion television. Absolutely, if you're interested. Just one thing that I'd like to ask you, though, because the fashion industry, of course, has been so devastated by this disease. It's, yeah. We're hearing about designers every day. Yeah, they're just, you know, sort of falling like flies.
It's taking so many people, you know.
There is such an amount of hypocrisy and ignorance that I've found going on in the world and in the fashion industry. That's why I'm quite delighted to hear that you have found that kind of support in the community.
Oh, yeah.
But don't you think that there is a lot of hypocrisy and ignorance still out there? I know many backers are pulling
terrible
out.
Ignorance, but that's because of what they're being fed. I mean, what makes a good headline? Dice Man has AIDS in the front of the Sunday World. I mean, there's a lot of... It's a very frightening thing. People are frightened of it, you know?
Of course they are.
Which is why, I mean, the amount of people are now going to say, oh my God, I've been shaking hands and drinking and eating with that man for the last 10 years.
Tom, you, one of the things you always did, you're sorely missed, I can tell you that. You really are
the
sorely
The letters that
missed.
Are sent, you've given us so much pleasure.
Absolutely. You know? But you had, one of your great things was this hugely lewd wink. Give us a wink.
Hey, can I... Tom is staying with us. Tom is staying with us, but I'm trying to keep kind of on top of time, and I want to introduce some music now. Stay with us and please just relax there for a few minutes, because I want to introduce some nice music to you now. Our next guests are